if it wasn't for your prompting, I would have just assumed, you know, no way I would have gotten anything. So I wanted to thank you.
No, we appreciate you growling a problem with us here.
Now, Tom O'Brien.
Welcome, folks. This is Tom O'Brien of TFNN. We go 5 days a week. We go 7.5 hours a day. We go 24 hours a day on the internet at TFNN.com. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. Hope everyone's having a great day, safe day. Let's make it a great night, folks. Love coming out of you makes you happy. The whole world can love you, but that's not the love that'll make you happy. What will make you happy is to share all the love you have inside of you. That is the love that'll make the difference. Market-wise, let's take a look at it out here. We have the Dow Industrials trading up 583. NASDAQ is up 238. S&P's up 67. That's a gain inside the NASDAQ, folks, of 1.7%. Inside the S&P's, 1.7. The Dow's trying to catch up here, 1.9 inside the Dow Industrials. Gold. Gold contract down $27.60, trading $18.33 an ounce. You got silver down $2.63, $26.78 an ounce. Light sweet crude caught a big bid out here. Up $1.14 right now, $54.69 a barrel. Now, we're going to get the API numbers out after the close out here today. Bottom line is that it looks like it's going to be a shot on oil. Oil looks like it wants to go to the $60 level. Notes and bonds. We have the 10-year down 7 ticks, 136.31. The 30-year off 17 at 168.15. The 10-year, folks, is still inside its larger range. You are coming down on tremendously lighter volume. And King Dollar. King Dollar broke topside yesterday, folks. Got out of the consolidation that's been in for 2 months. You're up another 236 ticks at 91.216. It looks like 92 to 92.50, 500 that is game. That's pretty impressive when you take a look at the oil market, that oil is moving like that with the dollar also moving topside. The euro is at 120. The yen is out here at 105.10. And the British pound's at 136 to one U.S. dollar. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. Give us a call, folks. Want to know what's going on in your world, in the world of the S&Ps. Let's take a look at them. What do you have? Well, we have the contraction of volume. You know, bottom line, my take here is that we're going to go up and test these highs, and I suspect it's not going to basically hold. The reason I'm saying that is that we have the nice so three separate times, folks, coming off these highs, going all the way back to December 1st, basically, we had come down with volume. Market shook it off in 2 seconds, came right back topside. That being said, this last time here, you get two separate days, big volume on the way down. Yesterday, what we did in the SPY, we did 75 million shares. You're at 40 right now. Bottom line, what I expect you're going to see out here is that you're going to go up and test this level, meaning the highs. We're at 382. No reason we can't go test this 386. And you have the contraction, though. When you have the contraction like this and you basically are going topside with nice price spread into highs or into swing points, that says quite a bit. NQs look like they're setting up the same way. NQs, yeah, they're not going to do another 10 million shares, 12 million shares into the close. Right now, we're 23. We did, yesterday, you did 35 million shares. We're 23 now. That'll probably bring it up to, it should bring it up to 30. But bottom line is that still very big contraction of volume. So this high is going to be really intriguing watching how this shakes out. Gold contract out here. They brought gold down. That being said, guess what? You're at 222,000 contracts. No big deal out here. You're coming into, I think we're coming into 275 with 304. Let's see. Okay, so we're coming into... Yeah, 276 and 278, and you're 222, you know. So bottom line is that, yeah, I think you can get a little bit lower here in the gold market. You know, we hit 1830 today. Maybe it's going to be another test of the 1830 level. Silver, we take a look at the silver market. They raised the limits in silver last night. They didn't raise them a lot either, by the way. They only raised them like $3,000. Silver coming back, 195,000 contracts traded right out here. And we take a look at this. Come on, baby. Yeah, and it's dramatically lighter volume. The silver contract looks to me that we hit 26.35, 26.13. is where you basically, you know, if you're a metal bull, you want to basically keep your eye on that level. What we haven't got out here today is any type of rejection of lower price. What we have got, however, is a big contraction of volume. If we go and take a look at the SLV, now the SLV's in a confirmed ABC structure on the way up, which is so cool. Why? Because you have a price projection out here about 36, and you know SLV came down. Now the SLV did reject this $24.41. Doesn't mean it won't be right back down. The SLV can get somewhere into about the 23.89 area. And what I expect when you see that, the bottom line, that's going to be a buy. We go take a look at the Treasury market, the 10-year. 10 years down on 1 million contracts. Now, that's really light volume in a monster way, too. What we have out here, there we go. The you're testing, look at that, you're testing 2.7 million contracts. And that's at 136.28, or at 136.31. And it's going to be all about this King Dollar, folks. The bottom line, King Dollar, what it did yesterday is that it broke topside, holding price today. So that's saying that good old King Dollar can get up to this 92.200 area to approximately the 92.500 area. So that, no doubt, is a big number. And for all you tigers and tigresses out there, we have a new tiger. Christina and Tom today, folks, 8:13 this morning. We got a new tiger, Tom. Check this out, folks. Check this out. He's 9 pounds, 8 ounces. He's a monster, man. It's amazing. Of course, mother's fine, child's fine, everyone's doing good. And we're going to have him growling and prowling. Tommy sent me a video of him growling already. It was hilarious, actually. Stay right there, folks, to come right back. Dow Industrials up 564, NASDAQ up 228, S&P's up 64. We'll come right back.